अब बताइए, इज द लैग बेटर नाउ? इज द लेटेंसी इंप्रूव नाउ? Is the lag, okay, problem now taken care of? All fine then? Write something, okay? Is it okay? Is the lag okay, all of you? Okay, cheek. These are problems related to the connectivity. The problem who am calling? I've not started any discussion, Bharti. I'm just okay. We have some problems related to the okay streaming. Okay. So what I was discussing is there are two type of questions that they ask you. Okay. We are doing models and theories. So one type of question which is conceptual question. Conceptual question. And my suggestion of the structuring is this. ये आपका structuring होगा. Start the question by definition or mention a bit of history of that theory. Okay, give a diagram, have the concepts, like concept number one, concept number two, concept number three. Then have a section where you mention application, maybe two or three paragraphs. And the conclusion should be about what are the limitations or what are the criticisms. Okay, this is the structure of the answer if the question is more conceptual and based on the theory. Like say, if they ask you, what is von Thunen's theory of agriculture location? Tell us von Thunen's theory given in 1829. Okay. A work of a German aristocrat. He wrote the book Isolated State, which was about the most optimum and the best location, okay, pattern for agricultural land use. It is one of the first, okay, locational theories in geography. His concept was based on, say something here, okay, and then give a diagram. Give a diagram, maybe make a circle or whatever you want to talk about, or one of the three triads talk about that. Then concepts mein aa jao, what is the concept of isolated state? What do you mean by locational rent? Okay, what is the concept of, okay, circular rings of locational patterns? Fir aap application pe aa jao, what in US, what in India maybe, what in Europe, and then come towards the limitations of, okay, normative assumptions related to, okay, rational man, economic man. So this is the arrangement of your answer if the question is conceptual. And I'm looking at approximately around 2 to 3 page answer. Isse bada nahi karna. But if the question is based on application directly, okay, more likely than not application aapka question banega, then there's a slight change. Start the answer by definition, mention a bit about history. Okay, then ye jo diagram hoga, this diagram, this should be more like a summary of the theory. Okay, use schematics, use flowcharts. Okay, use some, maybe if you can, some bullets mein aaja. And then directly start with application. Application 1, application 2, application 3, application in India. Okay, and end the answer again in limitation and criticism. Okay, this is the structure of the answer. If the question is more applied based, aapka main body banega application. Whereas if the question is conceptual, then application will be 1 or 2 paragraphs or 2 or 3 paragraphs and elaborate more on the concepts. Is that okay, all of you? Is that fine? Okay. And I can see most likely you will have more of application type of questions. Okay. Most likely you'll have application type of questions. Okay. So let's move on now. Now I'm starting with discussions on systems analysis in human geography. Systems analysis in human geography. I'm starting with this. The first point here, now it's like jottings. Okay, answer nahi bata rahe hain. It's like jottings. Now, first, you can try a definition. According to Preston James, a very famous writer, okay, who has done a lot of compilation, a very contemporary writer, Preston James, a system may be defined as, a whole that functions as a whole because of interlinkages of its components. Okay, so if systems analysis pe koi question puchta hai aapko, so this is the most likely definition you can start with. According to Preston James, okay, he defined systems as whole that functions as a whole because of interlinkages of its components, because of interlinkages of its parts. Okay, now 3 point remember, 8 point hai, that systems approach is a framework. Systems approach is a framework for studying. It is a framework for studying multivariate complex situations. Okay, what is systems approach? Systems approach is a framework. A system is a framework for studying anything which has too many variables. There are too many multivariate complex situations or multivariate complex phenomena. Phenomena. Okay. Isi mein add kar sakte hain that because geographical landscapes are complex, therefore systems analysis is most suitable. It is the most suitable tool, okay, for appreciating geographical events and geographical phenomena. Okay, so use this directly in your answers, please. Okay, so it is a framework for studying multivariate complex situations or phenomena, and because geography, okay, is a complex landscape or geographical landscape is complex, therefore it is the most suitable tool for appreciating geographical events and geographical phenomena. Iska history aapko pata hai. The history of this is, it was given by Ludwig von Bertalanffy, 1920s mein, okay, he talked about the general systems theory for biological life forms physiology, for studying the biological life forms physiology. Okay, studying how life forms operate. And in geography, the concept was introduced by B.J.L. Berry and Richard Shorley. It was introduced by B.J.L. Berry B.J.L. Berry and Richard Shorley in 1960s. So, ये आपको history पता है? Do mention, okay, in one or two sentences. Now, what I'm adding today is what I'll discuss right now. Now, a systems approach, okay, is based on the following properties of a system. Is based on the following properties of a system. Repetition. Preston James says that a system may be defined as a whole. Okay. System is defined as a whole because it functions like a whole due to its interlinking parts. There's something that operates like a whole system because its elements and parts are, okay, interlinked. No, theory was not given in 70s. Shreya, ye aapka galat concept ho gaya. The theory was given way back in 1920s. Ye 70 aapne galat likha. Or maybe did I make a print error here, writing error here? Okay. 1920s likha beta maine yahan par. 1920, not 70s. And B.J.L. Berry and Richard Shorley introduced, okay, the concept into geography in 1960s. Okay, so I'm moving on now. A systems approach. Now see, if they ask you a question based on the application, okay, system ka application kya hai, practical usage kya hai, this is the content you will use. A systems approach is based on the following properties of a system. Number one is, okay, the concept has a property of isomorphism. Okay, this concept has the property of isomorphism. Basically, isomorphism means, okay, something which is equal, something which is similar. Isomorphism ka matlab hota hai that this system can be used in any discipline and the properties remain the same. Okay. So if I'm talking about a property, say I have a system of atmosphere, and then maybe I have a system related to life forms. Maybe I have a system related to urban functioning. Okay. What do I mean by isomorphism, Sunoa? Say I've got three different systems. There is atmospheric system, maybe winds, temperature. There is a life form based system. Think of biodiversity wala system, socho aap. And maybe there is an urban entity, say Delhi metropolitan region, that works like a system. Isomorphism basically means the properties are such that, okay, in the system, the atmosphere ke jo rules hai, are same as, okay, the rules that can apply for life forms and rules that can apply for urban systems also. Okay, that is, rules that apply to the elements and working of the system or system in one abstraction are also applicable to applicable to other conditions. Other conditions. Like think of the law of thermodynamics. Law of thermodynamics applies to atmospheric systems, applies to biodiversity, applies to urban systems. Okay. Think of a law. Ek law hai, it's called as the law of complexities bolte hain. It says that the more complex a system, I'm just giving example, I repeat what I wrote here. What does isomorphism mean? That rules that apply to the elements and working of the system, the rules that apply to the elements and the working of the system in one abstraction are also applicable to other conditions, are also applicable to other abstractions. It's like, you know, I'm drawing a line on a paper and I draw a line maybe on the writing board. I draw a line on my, say, computer. The properties of the line will remain the same. Okay? This is what's called as isomorphism. So an example I said, say atmospheric system, I can apply the thermodynamics principle. Energy can neither be created nor destroyed. The same principle I can apply for life form, biodiversity and ecosystems. The same I can apply even for urban systems. Okay? The situations may be different, but the rules, not outcomes. The rules remain the same. The rule says, the more complex a system, okay, the more indispensable are its parts. Okay, the more complex a system, the more indispensable are its parts. The more specializations, okay, by the functioning parts. मतलब ये है कि अगर कोई system, ये एक system है, okay, if there are two elements working. And there is another system. Kya likhe pooch rahe ho beta, one sheet. What are you asking me? Did I miss something? Aap kuch pooch rahe ho mujhe. Kya poocha aapne comment mein? How much page left till now? Oh my goodness. Ab to theek hai. Koi baat nahi. Okay, koi baat nahi. Theek. So, एक रूल है, इज कॉल्ड एज द लॉ ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्सिटीज. द मोर कॉम्प्लेक्स अ सिस्टम, से दिस इज अ सिस्टम नंबर वन, दिस इज सिस्टम नंबर टू. सिस्टम वन में देर आर टू एलिमेंट्स एंड सिस्टम नंबर टू में मे बी देर आर वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव सिक्स सेवन एट नाइन टेन. एक और सिस्टम है, देर मे बी 100 एलिमेंट्स ऑपरेटिंग. सो विच ऑफ दीज थ्री इज मोर कॉम्प्लेक्स, एस वन, एस टू और एस थ्री, विच इज मोर कॉम्प्लेक्स? ओके, more complex is S3, because there are 100 elements here. And it says, the more complex the system, the more the elements will specialize. And therefore, the more indispensable are those parts. Okay, देखो, इसमें element 1 है, element 2 है. Okay, इसमें element 1, 2, 10 तक है. Okay, because both the elements are less, then both the elements are generalists. ठीक है, so अगर ये चला भी जाता है, ये generalist है, ये 10 काम कर लेगा. Okay, but in a very complex system, okay, there is lot of differentiation. A function performed by this cannot be performed by this, cannot be performed by this, cannot be performed by this. So if you remove one element, then this becomes more difficult to manage. Okay? This is one of the laws of complexities. Now, if the system's approach is isomorphic, then this law applies to all systems. Is it okay, all of you? Exactly. In rural economies, there are lesser elements. They are more simplistic. Okay. But as the urban economy becomes more complex, then you understand how difficult it is to manage. Exactly, human body bahut complex hai. Because complex, the stomach cannot operate like the lungs. The lungs can't operate like the heart. Bicycle, absolutely Danish, bicycle and car. Anyways, wo hamara discussion point nahi tha. Our discussion point was the systems operate on the basis of isomorphism. Okay, the rules that apply to elements and working of a system in one abstraction also apply to other conditions, also apply to other abstractions. So if you remove the elements, the system will become inefficient. That's why we talk about Earth mein, how each life form is important, because her life form performs some kind of specialized function. Why do we need the producers? Why do we need the carnivores? Why do we need the keystone species? Bicycle is a simple system. Okay, so isomorphism is a rule that applies to all systems. The systems ka property hai. The systems approach is isomorphic. Okay, this is one of the advantages of system. Okay, aap log digress kar rahe ho, theek hai? Mera discussion yahan nahi hai. My discussion is not this example. I am only saying that one of the properties of systems approach is that systems operate on the principle of isomorphism. Because they operate on the principle of isomorphism, systems can be used in any discipline. They can be used in any discipline. They're like a tool. Okay, they are agnostic to what type of subject you are studying. Okay, systems operate on the principle of isomorphism. The second property is systems. The second property is systems are frameworks. Systems are frameworks that unify and follow multidisciplinary approach. Yes, Omkar. Systems ke laws jo honge, wo consistent hote hain. That is why systems approach can be applied in any discipline. It's like addition. Whether you add two apples or you add two cars or you add two houses, you will always get, okay, numbers ka laws jo hai wo same rehta hai. Okay, so this is the property of isomorphism. Okay, let's move on to the second property. The systems framework, okay, they are based on the property that they unify. Systems framework unify, and therefore they follow multidisciplinary approach. They follow multidisciplinary approach. Okay. Systems can accommodate hierarchy in elements organization. They can accommodate hierarchy in elements organization. And systems operate on the principle or the concept of. Systems operate on the concept of cybernetics. On the concept of cybernetics. देखो ये कुछ properties हैं, okay? And these properties you can use across many answers. एक छोटे से box में आप डाल सकते हो. I'll explain what is the concept of cybernetics. Now see, cybernetics basically means a type of functioning that has the capacity of self-regulation. Okay, cybernetics, from a German word, the concept of cybernetics basically means, okay, a type of functioning that is capable of self-regulation. Think of human body, like a human body, you know, the way I keep my body temperature, I maintain, the way I am able to manage, okay, my hunger. Okay. Yes, exactly. Feedback mechanism, homeostasis, exactly. So this is a type of functioning that is capable of self-regulation. Self-regulation where the output of the systems can regulate the inputs in the later stages. Okay, so I'm looking at the question, what is it about the question? I'm looking at a question where the question is phrased, discuss the application of systems approach. So a box milik sakte ho. The systems approach has variety of applications because of the following properties. The systems are isomorphic in their properties. They are unifying multi-disciplinary approach. They can accommodate hierarchy in organization. They operate with the properties of cybernetics. Okay. They are capable of self-regulation systems. Okay. But the output of a system, so if the typical feedback loops, the output can come back as an input. Okay, so this is what is called as the cybernetics model. Systems operate on the cybernetics principle, a type of functioning that is capable of self-regulation. The fifth property is that systems are a type of, ye batao pehle main aapko pooch raha hu, do systems exist in reality? Anybody? Do systems exist in reality? Yes or no? System kya hai? Okay. System hai kya? What is a system? System is a way of studying something. Is system an entity? Koi cheez hai kya system? Is system an entity? What is system? System is a way of studying something. I hope you got the point here. System is not a thing. System is an approach. Exactly. System is a way of studying. So what does systems approach do? It helps us study the reality, okay, in a more simplified way. It helps us study the reality in a more manageable way. Okay, to maine bahar dekha, there is a ground, there are trees, there are grasses, there is a river, there are people having farms. And I take that up and I study that as an ecosystem where the things are linked to one another. So, ab batao, do systems exist in reality? Yes or no? Do systems exist in reality? No, they don't. Exactly. Systems is a simplified, okay, way of studying the reality. That's why we say exactly. Like feral model. Kya feral model ka system jo hai, wo kya nature mein hai kya feral's model? No. But I'm studying that so that I can appreciate the complexities. So can I say systems are actually an abstraction? Systems are abstractions of reality. Samajh mein aa raha hai? Systems are abstractions of reality. They are not the reality. Okay. And systems... So, agar system is a reflection of reality, okay, Can a system have infinite elements? Agar system reflects the reality, it's an abstraction of reality. Can a system have infinite elements? No, it cannot. Okay, मैंने बहुत carefully क्या किया है, I've picked up temperature, okay, of this area, I've picked up rainfall of this area, I've picked up winds of the area, and I've made a model using the systems approach. Okay, so ये जो system मैंने बनाया है, और I appreciate, this is manageable because it has limited number of elements. Okay? Yes. If it is infinite, it cannot be a system I can study. Is it okay, all of you? The system is an abstraction of the reality. And a system can accommodate only limited elements. That is why we say a system must have a boundary. ठीक है? If I remove boundary का मतलब क्या है? Then I do not know where the thing ends. So for convenience, a system is made to have a boundary. A system is an abstraction. Okay, a system can accommodate only limited elements, and hence, okay, systems abstraction with definite boundaries make understanding of real life events more manageable. Did you understand? Okay, these five properties of systems. The systems are based on the concept of isomorphism. A system is a unifying concept. Okay. A system has hierarchies. A system operates on the concept of cybernetics. Okay. A system is an abstraction of reality. It can accommodate only limited elements, and hence the systems, okay, will always have a definite boundary. And that is why it makes understanding of the real life events more manageable. So if I ask you now, suno, ye jo point likha hai aapne, what am I trying to answer? I'm trying to answer two things. What is the advantage of a systems approach in geography? What is the merit of using systems analysis in geography? Okay, and discuss the application of systems approach in human geography. So advantage kya hai? Yehi advantages hai. That it follows the principle of isomorphism. That it is a unifying concept. That it can accommodate hierarchies of elements. Kuch bada hai, kuch chota hai. Okay? The last point on the board. The systems, likho, systems are abstractions of reality. Systems are abstractions of reality. Systems can accommodate only limited elements. Systems can accommodate only limited elements. And hence, systems abstraction with definite boundaries. Systems abstraction with definite boundaries make understanding of real life events more manageable. Yes, absolutely. different systems can interact. So the hydrological system does interact with the atmospheric wind system. It does interact with the biological ecosystems. A fluvial system interacts with the geomorphic systems. Bilkul interaction hota hai. So do you understand one thing? Okay, which part clear ho gaya aapka, all of you? In our regular classes, what we teach is what is system, what are the elements of a system, what are the types of a system, what are the abstractions of system, and maybe one short paragraph on what are the applications. But I'm asking you a full length question, of maybe 25 marks or 20 marks. Aapko 200-300 word mein likhna hai. Discuss the merits of using systems analysis in geographical studies. Discuss the application and the merits of systems analysis in human geography. So, likh lo question. The question is, discuss the merits of systems analysis in human geography. Give a brief account of systems analysis applications. Okay, this is your question. Give a brief account of systems analysis applications in geography. So, ye pehla part jo maine bataya ki batao merits kya hai? What are the merits in the systems analysis in human geography? Why can we use it in human geography? So you start the answer by saying, typical answer, suno aap log, all of you. Okay. You start with the answer by saying, systems as defined by James is a whole that functions as a whole because of its interlinking parts. Systems approach is a type of a tool, is a type of a framework to study multivariate complex phenomena in nature. Okay. Geography and the study of geographical landscape involves the study of complex multivariate elements. Okay. So systems approach is a very convenient tool to study the complexities because of the following five properties. The systems approach is isomorphic. Okay, that is, the rules applicable in one system are also applicable to another system. That's why systems can use mathematics. Systems can use geometry. Okay, systems can use principles of natural sciences into geography. That makes the study more scientific. Okay, the systems approach has the property of isomorphism. Systems approach is a unifying approach. It is a multidisciplinary approach. We can use principles of biological life forms and sociological functioning and develop geography as an interdisciplinary subject. Okay, so ye isomorphism se hi aa raha hai. Okay, systems approach accommodates hierarchy. So urban studies ke hierarchy, natural ecosystems ke hierarchy, economic systems hierarchy can be studied through systems approach. Okay, systems approach is an abstraction. Yes, you can do that. It all depends on aap kaise likhna chahoge. Theek hai? But did you understand the whole purpose of why am I teaching you the properties of systems approach? Now, one thing I should have mentioned here. Dekho, because systems are abstractions of the reality, And the systems cannot have infinite elements. It cannot have infinite elements. And that a system must have a boundary. Now, ye dono reason ke wajah se, okay, the accuracy of a system depends on the elements identified and the boundaries drawn. Okay? Because of these two things. Hence, the accuracy and the applicability of systems approach depends on okay, how accurately elements are identified and how okay realistically boundaries are drawn. जितना ज्यादा आप elements identify कर सकते हो okay the more objectivity you have in drawing the boundaries and scaling up, more accurate will be your system. Can you see the importance of data here? A system is good enough to the extent of the data it uses. Did you all understand this point? The accuracy and applicability of systems approach depends on the accuracy and applicability of systems approach depends on how accurately elements are identified and how realistically boundaries are drawn. इसी से आपका आज understanding आएगा that the systems okay, accuracy depends on the data. आप कितना डेटा जेनरेट करते हो द क्वालिटी ऑफ योर डेटा हाउ वेल यू पेग द बाउंड्रीज एंड द लिमिट्स दैट विल डिसाइड हाउ गुड और बैड योर सिस्टम इज रिमेंबर फेरल्स मॉडल एंड हैडलीज मॉडल हु वाज यूजिंग मोर वेरिएशंस रिमेंबर हैडलीज मॉडल एंड फेरल्स मॉडल उसमें अब ऐड कर दो द मोर मॉडल ओके ग्लोबल सर्कुलेशन मॉडल्स याद है आपको जीसीएम मॉडल्स तीन तरह के मॉडल्स थे ना वन वॉज हैडलीज मॉडल वन वॉज फेरल्स मॉडल और एक था ग्लोबल सर्कुलेशन मॉडल्स विच ऑफ दीज थ्री यूज मोर अमाउंट ऑफ डेटा जीसीएम तो रियल टाइम डेटा यूज करता है सो विच ऑफ दीज थ्री विल मोर एक्यूरेट द मोर डेटा यू यूज The more variables you can add, the more accurate your system will be. Okay? So, now you know the basis of this discussion. Okay? Discuss the merits of using systems analysis in geography. Now, I'm quickly giving you what are the examples of applications. आप लिस्टिंग ले लो एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ ओके एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ सिस्टम्स अप्रोच ओके सो एक तो जानो आप ओके और मे बी दिस कुड बी समथिंग लाइक एन इंट्रोडक्शन ओके बिकॉज Systems approach as a framework or a tool that uses multivariate and complex spatial elements. Elements. Complex elements of space, because systems analysis as a framework or a tool that uses multivariate and complex elements of space like location, like distance, sprawl, density per area, okay, etc. Systems analysis is valuable in geography. Okay, write this down, please. I'll explain. Because systems analysis as a framework or a tool that uses multivariate and complex elements of space. Dekho, systems approach jo hai, I said ye tool hai. It's a tool. And geography is a subject of location. Geography is a subject that talks about distance. Geography talks about spread, also called as sprawl. Geography mein ek space element. Okay, then I'm saying, because systems approach can include all of this. Because if systems approach could not use this, then systems approach cannot be useful in geography. Okay. Because systems approach is capable of using these elements, systems mein aap distance dal sakte ho. Systems mein aap spread dal sakte ho. Remember von Thunen's model. You are using distance element, so von Thunen can be like a system. Okay. Because, now look at the sentence again. Because systems analysis as a framework or a tool that uses multivariate and complex elements of space. Okay. And what are the examples of the elements of space? Okay. Location is one example. Distance is an example. Sprawl is an example. Density per area's example. Therefore, systems analysis is valuable in geography. I'm literally dictating what your important sentences in your answers can be. Okay, so this will help you write better answers using these sentences. Is the discussion becoming too difficult for many of you, or are you all okay with this? Are you all okay? Main samjha pa raha hu aapko? Am I succeeding in explaining the concepts to you? Okay. Beta, isiliye na enrichment sessions mein jo hum padha sakte hain, I cannot teach in the regular classes. Regular classes mein you have all type of students. Agar main ye sab chhed dunga na, okay, language mein hi bachche halak ho jayenge. Okay, students will commit a suicide by the words that we use. So glad you have kept patience in the process. Okay, so I must keep some things for those who really can engage with us. Yes, yes, बिल्कुल आप ऐड कर सकते हो, ठीक है. अमरनाथ, आप यात्रा पे निकल गए थे शायद, okay, तो आपने कुछ मिस कर दिया. अमरनाथ, अब वापस आ गए हो तो कोई नहीं, सिद्धि प्राप्ति हो जाएगी, अभी नहीं तो कभी ना कभी. ओके, जब धाम गए हो तो भगवान तो हेल्प करेगा आपको, ठीक है, सल्वेशन निर्वाणा। और कुछ ना हो तो अंतिम संस्कार तो हो ही जाएगा ठीक ठाक से आपका यहां पर। God forbid. Bad joke, okay? I'm taking it back. Amarnath, bad joke, sorry. Yes, absolutely. जब अगर मिस किए हो तो नॉट मच आई कैन डू राइट नाउ। ओके, हाँ पहले पढ़ा तो दें। अच्छा, बाय द वे, सम ऑफ यू आर यू नो वे कंप्लेनिंग, सर आप आंसर जल्दी क्यों नहीं पोस्ट कर देते हैं? ओके, तो बेटा सी अंडरस्टैंड, सम ऑफ द आंसर्स आई हैव एज अ बैंक, अ लॉट ऑफ आंसर्स आर रिटन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ व्हाट आई टीच। आपको क्या चाहिए? यू वॉन्ट ऑल द ओल्ड आंसर्स और डू यू नीड फ्रेश आंसर्स? आपको क्या चाहिए बताओ? ओके, यू नीड बोथ, यस। ओके, तो कुछ बैंक वाले हैं जो पकड़ा देते हैं आपको, और कुछ फ्रेश हैं जो मैंने पढ़ा दिया है आप ही के साथ में, देयर आर 4, 5, 6 ऑफ देम सिटिंग हु आर लिसनिंग टू व्हाट आई एम टीचिंग। ठीक है, तो वो बैठ के लिखेंगे आंसर्स वंस और ट्वाइस, and then we will again modify that, give them comment, write again, okay, and then we will share with you, no? So aapko jo jaldi aise jaldi answer de do, how can I give the answer jab hamare answer bane hi nahi hai? Theek hai, haan Vishwanath, maybe today you have some problem with the portal, wo theek ho jayega, it does, okay, have some problem beech beech mein. How to evaluate? You can evaluate only on the basis of the answers I give you. और कोई तरीका मुझे पता नहीं है, ठीक है? Let's get back. Okay, so applications. Why is systems approach applicable to geography? Because systems approach can accommodate the space element. Systems approach can accommodate location and distance. It can incorporate sprawl. That is why it is also useful in geography. Okay, now what are the examples? Example number one, Shorley, okay, he used systems approach to analyze Davis and Peng's model. याद है आपको? ओके, दैट ही यूज सिस्टम्स अप्रोच टू एनालाइज डेविस एंड पेंग्स मॉडल। ओके, डेविस इज अ क्लोज सिस्टम्स अप्रोच, पेंग इज एन ओपन सिस्टम अप्रोच, सो आई थिंक यू नो दिस। ओके, ये सब क्लासेस में होता है, एलिमेंट्री ही है। सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल इज, नाउ नो दिस नेम्स प्लीज, लियोपोल्ड एंड ओके Langbein, Langbein. Okay, they use systems approach in the study of fluvial systems, and hydraulics. ये क्या था? जाने दीजिए. Simply write these names, please. Leopold and Langbein use systems approach in the study of fluvial systems and in hydraulics. Third, Berry, B-E-R-R-Y, Berry. He has studied urban and metropolitan regions in systems approach. Hydraulics, yes. Yes, this was part of channel morphology. Correct. Okay. So BJL Berry, he used systems approach in urban studies and in the studies of metropolitan regions. Okay, he had studied Okay. Urban planning. Planning and the problems of urban land uses. Okay. In Britain. Okay. So one sentence mein. Okay. The fourth is, okay, Peter Haggett. Yaad aa raha hai Peter Haggett? Anybody? Peter Haggett's ka kya kaam tha? 1960 mein, he gave the concept of, yes, locational analysis. Using systems analysis. He used systems approach to represent okay, spatial interactions using elements of geometry. Remember, we talked about what are nodes, what are links, what are flows, what is surface, what is hierarchy, and he also added diffusion. I hope you remember this concept. Ye part of syllabus hai aapka. Geographical thought mein maine padhaya hai. And all students, irrespective of whether you have been in my class or not, this you have to know. What is Peter Haggett's location analysis? Just do line beta. Okay. Short note, you can be asked on this because it's syllabus mein. The rest is I'm only listing down what are the applications. ठीक है, यस यस, दिस आर ऑल क्यूआर की बात हो रही है. दिस ऑल आफ्टर द क्वांटिटेटिव रेवोल्यूशन. ओके, अनदर एग्जांपल ऑफ सिस्टम्स अप्रोच. ओके, नाउ Haggett-Strand used systems approach, okay, in the study of diffusion of innovation. Okay. How ideas and innovation diffuse and spread because of neighborhood or contagion effect. याद है, ये मैंने पढ़ा दिया आपको geographical thought में. Okay, so if this is an idea, the idea spreads to the nearest person. It spreads to the nearest person. The idea comes to the nearest person. So ये जो spread है, okay, He has talked in terms of systems approach. And this is the contribution of the Lund School in Sweden. Thank you. Very importantly, is he say, okay, I'm still with this discussion. Ye jo Hagerstam ka study hai, okay. This is an example of using systems approach to dynamic functioning that involves time and space. Okay, Hagerstrand used systems approach in the study of diffusion of innovation, which is how ideas and innovation diffuse and spread because of neighborhood or contagion. Neighborhood or contagion effect. And this is the contribution of the Lund School in Sweden. Bas do line kafi hai. And then say that this is an example of systems approach to dynamic functioning. Dekho, in spatial analysis approach of QR, we remember time was ignored. Yaad aa raha hai aapko? While discussing time, I'd mentioned this. An example of time compression bolte hain isko. In spatial analysis approach of QR, okay, the models were static models. They ignored time and therefore, okay, systems approach use was limited. Okay, and what Hagerstrand does was this. He used systems approach, okay, for study of diffusion of innovation. He was able to use time aspect. The diffusion of innovation concept hai na? This is an example of time based phenomena. Or isme bhi systems use ho gaya. Okay, can I move on now? Hagerstrand used systems approach in the study of diffusion of innovation. A time-based phenomena hai ye. How ideas spread, how innovations diffuse using the neighborhood or contagion effect. How was लिमिट इन क्यू आर? हाँ, तो ये लिमिटेड यूज है ना. अगर आप सिस्टम्स अप्रोच में यू आर इग्नोरिंग टाइम, इजंट इट लिमिटेड यूज ऑफ सिस्टम्स अप्रोच? ओके, सिस्टम्स अप्रोच कैन यूज टाइम, बट क्यू आर में यूज नहीं कर रहे थे. ओके, आई कैन यूज माई पेन फॉर ड्रॉइंग, but I'm using only for writing. So I'm using my pen limited. Okay, exactly, one variable less. Hagerstrand brings in the time dimension. Now in more recent times, I'm moving on. Next, iske pehle kya tha? Point number 5 tha ye. Okay. in more recent times, systems approach has been used in planning, in spatial planning, okay? Now here I can use the systems approach accommodates, or systems approach includes cybernetics, uses, includes cybernetics principles. The role of feedback and regulation. Okay, इसीलिए I can use for planning. So इसके अंदर examples हैं. Okay, systems approach in agriculture planning, managing inputs, managing logistics and prices. Systems approach in environmental planning and in disaster management. Okay? Environmental planning and disaster management. Remember, example is, example batao kya hoga yahan par? See, example kya hoga? Watershed, yes, exactly. The watershed approach. Okay? Flood management. Okay. Yes, absolutely. Number C. Weather forecasting. Or India ke case mein, monsoon forecasting. Weather forecasting, monsoon forecasting. Okay. Using data from INSAT series, we have disaster warning systems. Agriculture planning, think of demand supply, no? Agar aap price gira doge, automatically the crops are not being produced. You subsidize the agriculture inputs, the farmers will take more. You increase the price, the farmers will not take. Okay? You give subsidies, you can develop some type of crops. This is cybernetics. It can regulate. Okay. Why in India, agriculture is not an incentive queue? Because it's self-regulation. It is not incentivized because of the prices and lack of single market. Okay? Yeah, MSP is one way of triggering more production. So weather forecasting, monsoon forecasting. Okay. You also have managing geomorphological disasters, such as slope stability management. Okay, rainfall, steepness of slope. Yeah, regulation. Man is part of all control systems. Okay, you regulate one element. Dekho, ye system mein kya hai? This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 elements. And they are all linked to one another. Okay. By regulating, by manipulating this, because of feedback system, this also can change. By regulating this, feedback aisa hai ki this can impact this one. Okay? That is why we say sugar cane. Don't ban sugar cane. Change the pricing of sugar cane. Okay. Don't encourage. Don't go and tell the farmers compulsory all of you grow sugar cane. No. Aap bas change kar do prices. Farmers apne aap sugar cane bada denge ya ghata denge. ठीक है. Example of cybernetics. Yes, RBI monitoring and how it changes the dynamics of liquidity. Absolutely. ठीक है. These are some of the contemporary examples of systems approach. Pavan, हम लोग बहुत आगे बढ़ गए हैं. CPT, Von Thun and Weber के बहुत आगे आ गए हैं. लिखो वो सब. ठीक है. But you realize the content here is more richer now. So you can have one point. Systems approach inadvertently was also used in CPT and the rest. ठीक है. Now we have gone much more deeper, 9,000 meters again deep. So weather forecasting, okay, disaster management, slope management, disaster responses, okay, all of this is part of systems approach. Appreciating, okay, ab isme add kar sakte ho the atmospheric climate change, okay. Understanding climate change impact. This also can use systems approach. Okay then, is it fine? Can we move on now? Thoda slow chal raha hai mere khayal se. I need to pick up pace. Theek hai, topic is a bit new topic. You have not done this. बेटा इसका कोई पेज नहीं है. देयर इज नो पेज. वन रेफरेंस इफ यू वांट आई कैन मेंशन. इफ यू हैव अधिकारी टेक्स्ट बुक, ये किताब है आपके पास. अगर नहीं है तो पेज नंबर लिख लो. पेज 209 में देयर इज सम लिस्ट ऑफ व्हाट आर द मॉडर्न एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ ज्योग्राफी इन इंडिया. पेज 209. में रिमोट सेंसिंग एंड GIS में. सो वेदर एंड क्लाइमेट, जियोमोर्फोलॉजी, हाइड्रोलॉजी एंड वाटर रिसोर्सेज, फॉरेस्ट एंड बायोडाइवर्सिटी. ओके. सो इफ यू हैव दिस बुक सुदीप्तो अधिकारी, पेज 209 में है. एंड देयर इज वन पैराग्राफ इन पेज नंबर 249. पेज 249 में पैराग्राफ 2 एंड पैराग्राफ 3. बेनेट, पेज 209 एंड 209, 2010 और 249 में थर्ड एंड फोर्थ पैरा. Third and fourth time. Bennett and Shorley, environmental systems. Okay. Something from that. Yeah, I think those who have been in the class, I have told them in the notes mein hoga aapke. 249, beta. Let me check. No, not 245. 245 mein diffusion of innovation hai. 249 mein hai. The applied aspect of of systems approach. Okay, let's move on then. The next topic. Okay. 5 minutes break. Are you all tired? Systems approach. Ek aur topic kar lete hain because I think we are moving a bit too slow today. Okay. because nay concepts hai, I don't want to exasperate you. The next topic is location theory. Location theories and location analysis. Okay. Now, you know the theories. You know von Thunen. You know about Weber's model. You know CPD model. So I'm not explaining all of this to you. Okay. I'm explaining something a bit more contemporary. Okay, and I'm discussing some applied aspects. Okay, जैसे कि write down some points. ठीक है, these kind of sentences आप use कर सकते हो in the answers. Let me say, location theories are at the heart of economic theories and regional economics. Okay, location theories are at the heart of economic theories and regional economics in geography. Okay, this is the main area where economics and regions, they kind of interact with one another. Think of von Thunen's theory, the theory of an agricultural region and the economics of using that region. Think of Weber, it's about that industrial and the urban region and the economics of how that location can be best used. Okay, it is the heart of this. Second point, okay, location theories are the basis of industrial organization and trade theories. Okay, they are the basis of industrial organization and trade theories. Particularly for planning optimal industrial location. Okay, so you're looking at planning aspects of industries, organization, and trade theories. Okay, they are important in deciding what is the optimal industrial location. Okay, conventionally, in location theories, conventionally, location theories considered economic location on the basis of physical distance and cost implications related to transport and labor. Okay, जो conventional location theories थे, think of Weber's model. Okay, think of von Thunen's model. They were based on the physical distance. Okay, exactly कितना दूर है physical distance and the cost implication related to transport and labor. Typically for Weber or transport, okay, in case of von Thuner. And this is also true for the central place theory. Now, recent times mein kya hua hai? In the recent times, how things have changed. Recent time mein, okay, four important additional considerations in location patterns. Number one is recent times, so 80s, 90s, 70s, probably the times when globalization has happened, the way we have technologies. So I'm not talking about von Thuner's 1820s ka theory now, or 1930s ka Kristaller theory now. You can talk about the more last 40, 50, 60 years. Okay. Listen, I'm going back to wo pala shayad miss kar gaye ho. Okay. Remember this, the pehla maine bataya slide, that I am getting you ready for a question on application based. Aur application jo hoga na, ye thoda recent wala hoga. Ye jo conventional concepts hain, you can handle it. The recent applications which are more dynamic, now this is where you need to be told something more here. Okay, the recent times mein how things have changed. So applied basis wahan se aa raha hai. Okay, in recent times, there have been four important additional considerations in location pattern. Ek bahut important consideration hai, the role of ICT, information technology. Information technology, internet, the role of okay, computers, okay, ICT technology, the role of data. Okay, the second important consideration has been, okay, behavioral basis in location. Okay, ab dekho, think of what's happened because of COVID. Okay, the decision not to locate industries in China, is this economically rational or this is purely a political emotional idea? What do you think? Okay, it's a political idea, emotional idea hai. Abhi aapke ek aur bade WhatsApp mein ghoom rahe hain, you know, Sonam Wangchu, kya Wanglu, are you aware of that? Yeah, Wangchu or Wanglu, Wangchuk. Okay, fine. Boycott China. If I go by economics, okay, we are not supposed to boycott China because it is location advantage in some ways. Industries India mein lana kuch year tak mehenga hoga. So now our choice is where to locate industries is now a behavioral choice. Behavioral choices which are affected by political developments. Behavioral choices decided by emotional factors. Emotional factors. Wangchuk, okay. Okay, your quantitative revolution models ignored behavioral basis. The quantitative revolution models and the early location theories, von Thuner, Kristaller, Weber, even Losch, These were ignoring the behavioral basis. But in recent times, the behavioral basis is also an important consideration. The third aspect is the role of MNCs and the role of FDI. The role of MNCs, the role of FDIs. Okay? So MNCs also decide, they decide location based on taxation policies, based on land acquisition policies, based on labor issues. MNCs and FDI also play a role in locational patterns. And the fourth point, this may add hair more or less, the laws and regulations. So basically, if you are asked about how has globalization impacted location pattern of economic activities, or think of a question, what is the contemporary relevance of location theories. ये discussion उसका part बनेगा. How has globalization impacted location pattern of economic activities? Or discuss the contemporary relevance of location theories. So you could start maybe from somewhere here. Conventionally, physical distance more important tha. Conventionally, transport and labor more important tha. These have been very important aspects of industry organization. Shuru karo yahan se, and then move on and say that recent times, how things have changed. So location of economic activities can no longer be explained on the basis of the conventional assumptions. Yaad aa raha hai assumptions kya kya hain? I'll come back on that. No longer can be explained on the basis of conventional assumptions. Economic man, rational man, perfect computation, isotropic surface. Yes. So how things have changed? So ESAB mein, you can have a couple of words here. The role of MNCs, FDI in deciding, the role of ICT in deciding. The role of, now this could be an important discussion. The behavioral basis of location, which includes preferences, it includes perceptions, it includes biases also. How, yes, absolutely, bullet train yahan fit ho jayega. It is no longer an example of least cost theories anymore. So now we conclude by saying that industrial or agriculture location continues to be the consequence of trade-offs between returns and mobility and resource cost. ये सेंटेंस समझ में आ रहा है? इंडस्ट्रियल एंड एग्रीकल्चर लोकेशन कंटिन्यूज टू बी द कॉन्सिक्वेंस ऑफ ट्रेड ऑफ बिटवीन वॉटिंग ऑफ ट्रेड ऑफ द टू थिंग्स यू ट्राइंग टू बैलेंस ऑन वन साइड हाउ मच एम आई अर्निंग ऑन वन साइड व्हाट एम आई स्पेंडिंग ओके इंडस्ट्रियल लोकेशंस कंटिन्यूज टू बी द कॉन्सिक्वेंस ऑफ ट्रेड ऑफ बिटवीन रिटर्न्स यहां पर रिटर्न्स लिखो या यहां पर रेवेन्यूज लिख लो रिटर्न्स और एड ऑन बिटवीन रेवेन्यू एंड मोबिलिटी मोबिलिटी मतलब है ट्रांसपोर्ट एंड रिसोर्स कॉस्ट बट ओके दीज आर नॉट डिसाइडेड solely by or solely on economic considerations of free market capitalism. सेंटेंस समझ में आ रहा है इंडस्ट्रियल और एग्रीकल्चर लोकेशन कंटिन्यूज टू बी द कॉन्सिक्वेंस ऑफ ट्रेड ऑफ बिटवीन रेवेन्यू एंड मोबिलिटी एंड रिसोर्स कॉस्ट ये ट्रेड ऑफ है ऑन वन साइड व्हाट आर माय अर्निंग वर्सेस व्हाट आर माय कॉस्ट द कॉस्ट इज ट्रांसपोर्ट कॉस्ट द कॉस्ट इज लेबर कॉस्ट ये अभी भी है बट अंडरस्टैंड that this trade-off is no longer because of economic considerations of free market capitalism. Okay? It is no longer free market capitalism. Okay? There are factors like specialized labor markets. There are factors like location conflicts. There are factors like metro and urban. Okay, clustering. Factors like price, competition, because of price manipulation. All this will distort the free market economies. Specialized labor markets. Okay. Like say think of Bangalore. Okay. Yes, a footloose industries may be better. It is no longer free market. Price manipulation. Yes, you're manipulating. You're giving discounts, no? Aapne discount coupon de diya. Okay, you're manipulating. So your price competition manipulate hota hai. This is not. So basically these are distortions in perfect competition. These are distortions in perfect competition. Yes, specialized locations, Bangladesh, Vietnam, correct. Specialized labor markets, okay. These include trade blocks. Trade blocks. But aap log applied, ab samajh mein aa raha hai kaise likhna hai aapko? In your questions, more and more these type of topics will be asked. Okay, aap isme examples de dena. Trade blocks hai, very nice. Talk about Vietnam. Sorry. Talk about Vietnam, talk about Bangladesh. Okay, these are specialized labor markets. Like India, in case of your software technology, specialized labor markets. In the future, okay, think of the specialized labor market for pharmaceutical industries. India is going to be a major production hub. Of course, a lot of those active drugs we get from China. Okay, the active ingredients and lete hain China se. But our specialized market advantage remains for some more time. Okay, so your location patterns are not decided by geometrical considerations. They are not decided by geometrical considerations. Okay, think of von Thunen. A geometry hai. Center, concentric circles. This is geometry. Your best location is at the center. Your pattern of price, okay, is geometrical graph. Ye coordinate geometry use kar rahe ho aap yahan par. Or think of CPT model, absolutely hexagon jo hai. This is geometrical considerations. Or think of location triangle. This is geometrical, distance as a factor. So I'm saying location patterns are not decided by geometrical considerations. Okay, now we have political considerations, price wars. Okay, we have got trade, okay, negotiations. Okay, all of you, I don't think on these topics I can move fast. Aap buri tarah phans jaoge. Theek hai, koi baat nahi. I will take an extra class if required. But ye pura applied hai beta. And if you know this much, even if they twist the topics, you still will have content. You'll know how to answer this when they be discussing applied aspects. ठीक है एनालिसिस एंड अप्रोच ओके वी यूज देम इंटरचेंजेबली बट द वर्ड एनालिसिस इज मोर रिलेटेड टू द मैथमेटिकल एस्पेक्ट्स ओके लाइक से डिटरमिनिज्म आई विल से एज अप्रोच आई विल नॉट से एनालिसिस Okay, behavioral is an approach. It's a way of looking at things. Analysis is a bit more mathematical, where I'm trying to put numbers, equations. Okay, objectivity, positivism, wo aa jayega aapka. Theek hai? But isme kya revise karoge? You can revise entire models and theories. To aapko pata hi hai, maine bataya aapko, maine mega revise entire models and theories. After systems approach, location theory kara rahe hain, I've got two or three more topics to take up. Or you could not log in earlier. have done two topics, systems approach and location theories ka application. Okay, so if you want to revise entire models and theories. I had kept a target of 3 topics, but mujhe lag nahi raha hai kya match kar paye. Theek hai, I'll start off the 3rd topic. Okay. Can I move on? Next class. Bade jaldi aap log thak jate ho meri jaan. ऐसे कैसे देश चलाओगे बताओ. देखिए छुट्टी ब्रेक स्ट्रेच इट सर एग्जाम इज फॉर 3 आवर्स ऐसे कैसे थक जाओगे. फुल एनर्जेटिक है. इट इज डिफिकल्ट ऑनलाइन बेटा. चेंज. Okay, things have changed and I do not think we can ever go back to our early normal. Aapka yahi rahega September, October tak. Okay, haan, Shiva bhi hai, Amarnath bhi hamare saath hai, Omkar bhi hai. Beta, yehi to Shivalaya hi ho gaya hamara. So, koi problem nahi hai. COVID bhi hai. All of you take care, okay? COVID is still around. Take care. Corona Devi. Okay. Now we come to the next topic. Loss modification. Loss modification. Just a minute. I think I have a call. Guys, I think we'll stop here today because I have promised something to my son. Usko bola tha main 8 baje we'll start off. So he has called to remind me. Theek hai? So theek hai, I'll continue tomorrow. Tomorrow, I think we have a class tomorrow or today or Monday. Kab hai hamara? Kal hai na hamara? I forget the dates. We have a class tomorrow. And we have a class on 20th. If required, I'll extend the class by 1 more day. Agar nahi kar paate hain, 14th class hai aur ek 20th ko class hai. Theek hai? Haan, to subah essays hai, shaam ko geography hai. Kya dikkat hai? Main nahi padhana hai aapko. Kaise overlap ho sakta hai? Pavan? Oh, Pavan. Theek hai? Chalo, theek hai. Revise. We will catch up. Okay, tomorrow, same time. Bye-bye. Take care. Okay.